Messoud or Messoud, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Now, this is my first ever video. Some of you guys are probably wondering what's going to be the content of my video. I'm going to give you a wide range of lifestyle, motivation, and I want to show you guys what I get up to on a daily basis. So just follow me on the journey. Now, I have a lot of shopping to pick up, guys. I bought some stuff from Prada, Moncler, Selfridges. I've spent over £5,000 on drip, which I'm going to pick up right now. I'm also going to do a £400,000 transfer, but I'll speak more about that later in the vlog. For now, guys, I'm off to Sloane Street. I'll see you there. Now, as you guys know, it's my first video. I'm quite new to this YouTube life, so I forgot to tell you to make sure you follow me on Instagram, which is gonna be right here. Snapchat's gonna be right here, and you can follow me on Facebook too. Please smash the like button. Make sure you subscribe to me. I've got a lot of videos coming soon. I'll leave the talking for now. See you in Sloane Street. Now, the first stop is Selfridges. I'm so excited to pick up the Gucci tracksuit that I've ordered in. Now, due to the pandemic, we're not allowed to go into stores. It's just a click and collect. So I'm gonna be going to Selfridges, then Prada, then Moncler, and I've also got a pair of Cartier glasses I'm so excited to see. But don't worry about it, guys. I'm gonna show you all of the drip when we go back to the apartment. Now, guys, we're finally here. I'm at the click and collect section of Selfridges. Now, they're gonna ask for probably ID and proof of the card that I paid with online. So I'm gonna give them all of the details and come out with the drip.
Draco. Soldier. She make it clap, clap.
087.
Yep.
613.
That's for Jordan.
Yeah. So, guys, I've picked up my Selfridges item. We haven't got much time. I'm off to Prada. We've got literally about 35 minutes to get there, so I need to go.
Prada, Sloane Street.
Sloane Street, Prada.
I've been done right through another nigga city. I got a brand new Draco with me. Clip got 33 Scotty Pippen, bitch nigga.
So now I'm outside Prada. I think you have to collect it here. It looks like you have to collect it here. There is a number to call. So what I'm gonna do is call this number, and the person assisting me is Nabila, I think her name is. So she's gonna come out with the items. Of course, you're not allowed anywhere near the store or anywhere inside it. I'm gonna give them a call now. So, guys, I'm obviously collecting my Prada. We now need to go to Moncler, which is straight down. I need to collect my mum's jacket. I've got a gift for her. We're running. We've got 20 minutes. So I'm outside Moncler. We're literally in a hurry. I need to go to Arthur Morris as well. I've got 10 minutes to do everything. We're outside now. I think I need to call her. I think they're actually letting us in the stores, I'm not too sure.
Who asked you?
Was a girl?
No, just wanted to know her name.
Melissa.
Melissa. Melissa, yeah. Is it Clooney? Jacket or?
Female, woman.
Okay, perfect. I have it here. Just wanted to make sure.
I thought they was going to let us into the store, but no, we're not allowed. But this is a new Moncler actually. They used to be, for those of you who know about Sloane Street, they used to be all the way down there. They've moved to here, which is literally opposite Fendi. It took us a little while to kind of find it. But I'm used to it being, you know, this is a gift for my mum, you know. Like, guys, always respect your parents. I try to give my mum gifts all the time, whenever I can.
With the fur, yeah?
Yes. Thank you so much.
Have a great YouTube.
Thank you. So, guys, I've collected the Moncler. We need to rush off to Arthur Morris. I've got Cartier glasses that I'm going to pick up. So, I gotta go. I'm outside Arthur Morris. This is where I get all my glasses. And fun fact, I literally purchased
these Cartier shades that I'm gonna pick up about 5 months ago, and I've paid for it. I just haven't collected it because I never really needed to use it. But I felt like, you know what, for the vlog, I'll come and collect it and show you guys. It's a beautiful piece coming.
No,
I'm
good.
So
hello.
Yeah. My dad's a digi, the schedule busy. My head in a hoodie, my shorty a goodie. My cousins are crazy, my cousins like boogie. Life is amazing, it is what it should be.
Yeah, that's just crappy.
Yes. Guys, what do you think? Let me know in the comment section below. These are my Cartier glasses. I put a bit of brown tint on it. Let me know in the comment section. Really nice. And I've even got this one, I'll show you guys. I've got a blue pair. I've got a blue pair here. And of course, this is the one I've just got. I really think they're nice. Let me know in the comment section. Make sure you like it. Yeah, I really like it. I'm really
happy, yeah.
Yeah. The only thing is with this one, this is a bit like flimsy.
Yeah, it can be from paper, that's my opinion.
Please, yeah?
Yeah.
So guys, this is the plug for the best glasses in Knightsbridge. In fact, the best in London. I must say, I always get my glasses from them. They've got what brands? Say, tell them the brands. Tell them the brands.
We have Cartier, Lindberg,
Dita, Gucci,
literally,
guys. Look at them over there. So guys, if you're gonna get glasses, make sure you come to Ultramorris. I'll get the card, I can show them there. As you can see, 11 Bishop Place, SW3 1NQ in Knightsbridge.
Hey, slip, slide, trying to provide for me.
So guys, I've just got in the cab. This click and collect stuff isn't easy. I've been walking around central London trying to find the right entrances to the stores to pick up the drip. But guys, we finally done it. But I'm feeling very tired. I'm quite hungry. So what I've done is I've ordered some hakkasan. Don't worry, I'm going to show you the food when we get back into the apartment. I'll show you all the drip. Feeling a bit tired now. Just want to get the food, get back to the apartment. And guys, I'll see you when I'm there. So I've just landed back in the apartment. You can see the shades are looking really good. I can't lie, I'm gassed. Let me know in the comments section how you're feeling about them. I think they're really cool, but you can see I've got the food ready. I am so hungry. Can't wait to have some prawns. We've got the noodles there. We've got the beef. We've got the duck salad. We've got the steamed rice. Guys, let me just have my meal. I'll show you the drip after. So I've just had my dinner, feeling a bit more energetic. Let me show you the drip. This is probably the one I'm most excited about. This is my Gucci tracksuit. It's the KS edition. I'm not too sure if you guys have seen it before. I'm excited to actually show you guys. Okay. Now guys, let me know in the comment section what you think of these. This isn't the traditional Gucci item you would see. Now, what do you guys think of these? I think it's really cool. It's the Gucci KS edition. It's got the little Gucci logo at the back. I think it's a cool vibe, especially coming into spring. I'm gonna rock this a lot. Let me know in the comment section what you think. It also comes with a top as well. You can rock this with jeans. But of course, I probably wear it with trousers as a matching tracksuit. Really cool. I'm a massive fan of this, man. I think this is something I'm definitely going to be wearing a lot. And of course, guys, I've got the Prada. This is another tracksuit which I think is going to look really cool on me. Now, this is the white. These are the trousers. Prada are kind of coming back, they're popping. Let me know what you think. You can see the little logo here. I remember like during, I would say 2009 and 2010, Prada were really, really, really at the top of their game. And I think they're back, I must say. This tracksuit is clean. And it also comes with the top half as well. Let me know what you think in the comment section. This is the hoodie. Quite nice, I must say. So that's definitely something I'm going to be wearing as well. And I've also got a gift for my mum. A Moncler overcoat.
with fur as well. Such a vibe. I think my mom's gonna really like this, I must say. I must say, guys. Let me know, man. You should be buying gifts for your parents often, you know, make them happy. Comes with fur. Let me know what you think. I think this is really cool, man. It's about 1.5 for this, but I think she's gonna like it. Moncler have never let me down when it comes down to jackets, and I think this is the perfect gift for my mum. Now guys, I'm really tired. I've shown you all the drip. If you want to see some of the Dior drip that I've picked up over the past week, I can show you that. In fact, I'm going to show you that in a few moments. Now, over the past week, I've been going very hard in Dior. Now, these are my favorite B22 colorways. I think this is one of the best ones alongside the pink one. You can see the pink one on my Instagram. I posted a pic. Please add me on Instagram. It's going to be right here. But guys, this is definitely one of the best B22 colorways. I'm also going hard on the B23s. I think these lot remind me a lot about Converses, these trainers. Had to get two of them. Which one do you think is the best? Let me know in the comment section. I think this one's got a little bit more to it. This is just a colorful one. Which one's the best? Let me know. I've also had to get myself a shirt. Guys, you cannot go wrong with a shirt like this. Let me know what you think. I think this is probably the best shirt I have. And I'm going really hard on the Dior oblique pattern. You can see I've even got the bag as well. Let me know what you think of these as well. I think, yeah, this is definitely the best bag I have. I had to get the scarf. This is full cashmere. This cost me over a grand. Can you imagine? Over a grand on a scarf. I've definitely come a long way. Oops. Let me know what you think. It's pretty warm. And I pretty much think this is the best style Dior have in their scarf. This clothes ain't cheap though, guys. It's costing me over £7,000 for this. Also had to get the silk scarf. I probably would wear this in the summer, springtime. But I think this is a real cool vibe. It's also, like, you can see blue. And this is a bit darker as well. You can see it's green. I think it's green and blue. I don't know, but green here. And I think blue's on this side. It's definitely different colors on each side, which is also cool. And I've also got myself the gilet. This is probably the best gilet Dior I've ever made. It's got a nice little pattern to it. It's not too much. And you can see it has got the little badge at the top. And I think this is a real cool vibe. Let me know what you think in the comments section. Now, of course, guys, I'm going really hard in Dior. I also think Louis Vuitton is doing quite well as well. Prada are up there, but Dior is definitely one of my favorite bands at the moment. Now, this ends day one quite smoothly. Tomorrow, we're going to be making a transfer of over $400,000. And I know this is the moment that a lot of you guys have been waiting for. I'll see you tomorrow in the morning. We're now in day two of the vlog, and today I'm going to be making a transfer of £70,000 whilst also clearing a cheque of just under $400,000. Now, I'm not going to tell you what the reason is for just yet, but follow me on the journey and you'll find out. Now, before I leave, guys, I'm going to have my breakfast. You can see I've got a glass of orange juice, got the avocados with toast, halal sausages, eggs and some beans. Now, breakfast is the most important meal of the day, so please always try and make sure you have it every morning. So guys, I'm just outside the bank. I'm just about to cash a check of £275,000, which is just under $400,000. I'm not sure if they're gonna let me vlog inside, but we'll just have to go ahead with it and see what happens. I'm not sure if they're gonna let me vlog. We're gonna make a check deposit.
So I'm just waiting for the bank manager to kind of sort out for me to hire me.
Now guys, it is freezing outside, but unfortunately the manager said I'm not allowed to vlog inside. It's understandable, we're in a bank, we shouldn't be vlogging anyway. But what's actually happening is the manager's gonna get me a new actual check that I'm gonna be using to deposit into my personal account. So I'm gonna take the new check, take it to HSBC and deposit the whole amount inside. I'm also gonna make a £70,000 transfer and I'll let you know what that's about later on in the vlog. But guys, it is freezing, it said 10 minutes. So I'm gonna go inside, wait for the new check, go to HSBC, deposit the check, transfer 70K, see you later.
So guys, they've just given me the check. So what I'm gonna do now is go to HSBC and deposit it. So just follow me. And actually, I'll be vlogging, I'm sorry.
See you later.
Bye. So yeah, I've got it here. HSBC is not too far actually, it's just literally down the road. So I'm going to do that and then at the same time make a transfer. So now guys, I'm in HSBC. I bank with HSBC Premier, so they give you extra amenities and stuff, which is good. So if you turn around here, you'll be able to see, okay, I'm not sure you're allowed to actually video in here, but if you come down, you'll see the Premier. So I'm back with HSBC Premier, so they're one of the best banks for Premier accounts. So I'm going to go in there, make the transfer. So of course it is a large transaction, so I have to stay here for 20 minutes while they set things up. It's been about maybe 15 minutes. We actually came here early. It's currently maybe, what time is it? 10:13. So we came here quite early, just to make sure everything's done on time. I don't want it to get too crowded. But I'll let you know how it goes. She said 20 minutes. Probably got about 5 minutes left to wait. So we'll see how things go. So guys, we're finally in the room. If you look around, it's like a little closed up room. And usually with a large transaction, I would be with a representative from HSBC who's going to help me do the transfer. But because of the pandemic and COVID and stuff like that, the distancing, she's going to apparently call me on here and literally let the transfer go through. I don't know what she actually meant, but she's going to give me a call. I'm going to pick up and literally make the transfer go. She's in the room over there. So it's a new way of doing it. And I'm just excited to see how this is going to plan out. Hello? Yeah, it is.
Yeah, so it's just about
putting
this payment for you.
Thanks.
Can you tell me a little bit about what it's for?
Okay, so basically it's for an investment. I'm buying an apartment overseas.
Okay.
So yeah, I'm sending off 70K and I'm going to send the remainder later on in the year. It's an apartment that hasn't been built yet. So that's why I'm not selling the full amount right away. I just want to see their progress and stuff and then I'm going to send the whole amount. So yeah, it's for an investment to be fair. It is overseas, I've got their details.
Okay, fantastic. What country is it?
Ethiopia, which is where my family of origin is.
Okay, no problem. Now, 70K that came in 2 days ago into this account, what's the cost of those funds?
That's my company paying me a dividend.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
And
I'm the director of that company.
Where's the money account? What bank is it in?
It's with Tide.
Account,
that's my business bank account, yeah. And I paid myself a dividend of 70K in order for me to then purchase the apartment.
Yeah, is there any reason it came into the personal account? Is it because it's like a personal purchase?
Yeah, because in Ethiopia, I was going to make my company buy it, but they don't allow companies, like in Ethiopia, the rule is companies can't buy the house under a company. So I've had to pay myself a dividend to then pay for the apartment, if that makes sense.
Yeah, absolutely makes sense. But in terms of details, have you got like an IBAN?
Yeah, I've got all of that information, yeah, I do.
Okay, fantastic. Can I take that? I'm going to write it down first before I input it. So when you're ready, you can just give me all the information you've got. That's great.
Alright, no worries.
Do you want to send it in pound sterling or do you want to convert the currency?
No, they would want it in dollars.
In US dollars?
Okay. Yes.
So you want £20,000 worth of US dollars?
No, it's £70,000 converted into dollars, so I think it's over $100,000.
Okay, so I'll give you a call back when I've got the rate for that to tell you what that will be.
So guys, yeah, so it's quite different. She's processing the transfer on the phone. She's literally just next door, so when I leave the bank, I'll show you guys, it's crazy. Things are just different, but as long as the payment goes through, I'm happy anyway.
Customer, signature.
Amazon?
No, that's for you, so you don't need to sign it on. You just write your name and put it out and then put a date on there. Thank you. Anything else I can help with?
In regards to this transaction or?
Anything.
Yeah, I want to deposit a cheque of 275,000. This is not paid as a dividend into my account.
Okay.
It's gonna it's a loan from my company. So yeah, don't worry, that's tax purposes anyway.
Yeah,
but yeah, it's just like,
you wanna pay that in? Just head over to the cashiers there. Let me grab your payment first, and then you can just pop it over to them.
Oh, is it not possible to put it into the machines upstairs?
You can actually, yeah. There's it's going into your personal account.
Into this account, yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. There's slips upstairs that you can use.
Alright. Yeah.
Anything else you need?
So is it? Is it all done?
Yeah, there's nothing else for us to do. So now it goes through our check-in teams.
Okay.
So it should leave your account today.
It'll leave my account today. Mm-hmm. And how long would it take to?
We say up to 8 working days in countries outside the EU. It's usually quicker than that though, to be honest.
Of course, but it's all been sorted?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's
good. We're gonna put a complaint on the system for you as well. And there is a £9 charge for that, but we're gonna make sure that's refunded to you.
Thank you.
Obviously, you were here a long time.
All right then, thank you. Do you have like a receipt to show that's completed? Or?
Just that, that's for you to keep.
Okay.
So it should have all the reference numbers on there. So if there is any issues, but it's all on the system anyway. But yeah, keep hold of that.
All right, no worries. So the next step is to deposit
that. Deposit that, yeah. So you can either do that at the counter or upstairs on the machine, up to you.
Okay, cool. And how long do these take to clear?
So midnight tomorrow.
We'll be in.
So Saturday morning, available.
Thank you so much. All right, then, thank you. So guys, it's all been done. £70,000 transferred. And of course we'll speak more about this later on in the vlog. I'll explain to you of course why I've done it and all that. I'm sure you guys are probably thinking, okay John, why have you done it? Don't worry, I will be explaining to you guys now. Let me just cash in the £275,000 check. I don't know if you guys, but it reminds me a bit about Floyd. I don't know if you see him, but he always waves around checks of like 100 million from his fight. So I feel a bit like Floyd, smaller amount. We'll get there, don't worry. Soon this will be 275 million. But guys, yeah, let me just cash in the check. And then what we're gonna do after that is we're gonna go to Jeeves. I've got a whole load of clothes to pick up. So I'm gonna do that. And then we'll be back to the apartment. So guys, we've just done everything we need to do in the bank. I've cleared the check, I've transferred the money overseas, so now I'm outside Jeeves. And Jeeves is the best laundrette in London. They're located on Pont Street, which is next to Harrods. I've got a lot of clothes to pick up, and to be fair guys, they're not too cheap, they're quite expensive, but they're definitely of a high quality. And guys, it's freezing outside, so I'll see you inside. This one's quite big in comparison to the other one in Mayfair.
Hi.
Hello, how are you doing?
I've
got quite a lot of stuff to pick up. Do you need a suit?
Yes. How are you?
Yeah, not too bad. It's actually freezing cold. I am freezing.
Hello,
nice. Yeah, guys, a lot of drip. God, so much drip. You just have to see.
Yeah, my friend, yeah.
Yeah,
have
you taken pictures
of him? Yeah, from the vlog, you know.
Oh.
Yeah. Thank you. This is, but we've probably got that as well. We've got the Derek Rose. We've got the Gucci. We've got the Gucci again. We've got the Derek Rose again. We've got the Dior. I've left this in there for a while. We've got the Derek Rose again. Oh, we've got Derek Rose T. Now, guys, if you're wondering what Derek Rose is, Derek Rose is the best. T-shirts, literally like plain t-shirts, you can't go wrong.
Drake says it in a bar, I think he goes, Derek Rose, my knee up before I've got something like that. Kick the bar. Down. But I love art. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. We've got that. And we've got my socks.
Got the kitchen sink as well.
The kitchen sink, now. We've also got the Moncler trousers. So, this is crazy. You can even see here, guys, they've been appointed by the Prince of Wales as London's finest dry cleaners. Not just anyone, the Prince of Wales. So, that just goes to show the quality. So, if you've got like expensive clothing, make sure you hit up Jeeves. So I've just got back to the apartment. I'm feeling very tired. It's been a very long day. I've been up since about maybe 6 a.m. So yeah, it's been a very long day, but I've got a facial, guys. I feel like my skin's okay, but you know, you need to get yourself pampered up sometime. So I've got a facial in about a couple of hours. So you guys tune in. I'm very tired, can't speak for too long, but see when I get the facial. So I've just got my facial done. Their Instagram is thepamphrom_. Make sure you add them up. Now guys, you can see my face is sparkling right now. It gives me a nice little relaxed vibe for the evening. It's not a promo, by the way, so I definitely mean what I say. Guys, make sure you add them. The service is brilliant. Now, I know a lot of you guys are probably thinking, okay, Jordan, what was that transfer for? Now, one thing I'm heavy on investments. It's all about investing for today, so that you have a better future later on in life. And I feel like with social media, a lot of people want to have the best cars, the best drip, the best watches, and they get kind of sidetracked into what's actually important. In reality, you need to make sure your priorities are straight. Before you buy the cars, the drip, make sure you've got your investments. Make sure your foundations are solid. And of course, I understand when you have Instagram, you want to have the best pictures. Don't spend beyond your means, always invest. I've got so many investments that I've made back home in Ethiopia, and my investments are just doubling and doubling and doubling. I'm looking to buy more properties in London, Coventry, Birmingham. I'm actually trying to build an empire, and I feel like a lot of you guys want to do it as well, but you're kind of sad. Okay, I want to get the best watch, I want to get the best car just to impress social media, when that's not what we're doing this for. We don't make all this money to then blow it. Make sure you guys are making investments. And of course, I'm going to show you guys my investments in other vlogs. I'm going to actually give you, of course, the lifestyle. I want you guys to get motivated, but I want to show you what's really important. I want to show you some of my investments, the properties I buy, things that I'm doing to double my money. And I feel like a lot of you guys kind of need to do that more often. Kind of just don't think about social media too much. Think about what's actually important. All the richest people in the world invested their money wisely. So guys, that kind of brings the vlog to an end. I want you guys to follow me on Instagram. It's going to be around here. Snapchat's going to be around here. You can add me on Facebook. It's going to be around here. So guys, that brings the vlog to an end. I want you guys to have a great day, and I'll see you in the next vlog.